I want to ask you about your opponent, Donald Trump.
Okay.
I was a little bit surprised. People might be surprised to hear that you have never interacted with him, met him face to face. That's going to change soon. But what I want to ask you about is what he said last month. He suggested that you happened to turn black recently for political purposes, questioning a core part of your identity.
Yeah. Any same old tired playbook. Next question, please.
That's it?
That's it.
Hey, quick question. When are we going to ask Trump, when did he turn black? Why is he so many shades darker than Kamala? Why? You see Jasmine Crawford down there? Why is he? I want you to look around his eyes and inside of his ears and his hairline. That's his skin tone. When did he turn black? Interesting.
What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, it seems that Kamala Harris has turned a bad situation into a worse situation. Well, how does she do that? After making an appearance with her useless vice presidential candidate on this pre-recorded CNN interview, where Dana Bash asked her about the black issue, you know, where Donald Trump questioned her blackness, knowing that she said she was Indian at one point and said she was black at another point. You're confusing the people. Can we have some clarity? Dana Bash brought it up in that pre-recorded interview, and it might've got caught right in her throat as she tried to get it out, but it just wouldn't come out. She said, next question, please. I don't want to answer that. Next question.
I'm black.
Yes.
And I'm proud of being black.
Absolutely.
And I was born black. I will die black. And I'm proud of being black. And I'm not going to make any excuses for anybody because they don't understand.
Well, after that debacle, seems like she's been trying to recover some brownie points with the community. And of course, how would you do that when the black folks think you're out here and it's all cap? How you going to get back from that? How you get your get back? You got to be able to relate to the community, right? You got to be able to speak their language, right? You got to be able to scratch them where they itch, right? Food. That's what we'll do. We'll talk food. You know, them collard greens in the bathtub. Well, y'all, on her TikTok, Kamala Harris has released a new video of a spontaneous impromptu exchange with a black woman to talk food. And she came up with this plain old recipe. Seemed like she had it cocked and ready. Seemed like this woman was probably a plant. The woman was probably in on the whole thing. But she asked her about her recipe for cooking her little green situation. And it sounded to me, y'all, like, that ain't black food. Sound like you might be putting raisins off in a potato salad, Kamala Harris.
I have a friend who had a Christmas party, Christmas Eve every year, and she asked me to make the greens for a party every year. And I am not lying to you that I would make so many greens that I'd need to wash them in the bathtub. Okay. I'm telling you the truth.
So how do you make your greens? Do you put turkey in them? Do you
bacon.
Nice. My grandma
I do bacon.
She's put
garlic.
Vinegar.
I put white vinegar.
Yes.
I do. So I start with, I slice up my garlic. Uh-huh. Well, but no, first I fry, chop up the bacon and get all that fat going. Then I put garlic, some chili peppers,
yes,
and then a lot of water and some, a little chicken stock.
Okay.
And I let it go for a while before I put the greens in. And then, right, so you get that going and all that flavor, and then I put the greens in for a couple hours. Then I do vinegar, and then I cheat and do a little Tabasco.
No, that's okay.
Yeah, because but Tabasco of all, like, I like Louisiana hot sauce, but Tabasco has that right amount of vinegar.
Yeah.
And that's how I do my greens.
I see why you get invited
every
year.
Auntie, what are you doing?
Herbs from my garden. Onion, lemon,
What is this process of the juice and then?
Come on, honey. It's a baster and I'm the juice. You baste.
What are you doing now?
Caramelizing the onions, Nina.
Tell me more. Tell me more.
No, you need to.
I need to learn.
I'm trying to teach you. You're more interested in being a video.
Get in my belly.
Get in my belly.
All right, Marlon, so I know how to make a mean pot of greens. In fact, people used to ask me to make greens for them for Christmas. One year, I had so many that I had to wash that we ended up washing them in the bathtub. So I am not playing around. So what you...
The fact that some of y'all are still questioning if Kamala's black, her nieces and nephew call her auntie. They call her auntie. I think that is enough evidence that that woman is black, because the only people that call their aunt auntie is black folks. Like, let's be for real, okay? So we can stop questioning it. Thanks.
One video says, oh, well, she gotta be black because in the video with her nieces and nephews where she was cooking in the kitchen, they call her auntie. And only black folks call they aunt auntie. Are we really that gullible, y'all? Are we really that simple? Such that we can be figured out by any and everybody, because we are not complex at all. We just surface level. We not deep at all. Is that what we are? Nah, but that's what they think we are. So this woman pulls out this recipe she probably got from Google. Instead of getting on this very platform, sis, you could have went over to Smoking and Grilling with AB. You could have went over to Coop Can Cook. You could have went anywhere. You could have went over to Darius Cooks. You could have went anywhere on this platform and got a recipe that sounded real. A recipe that tasted real. We could taste it just by hearing you speak it. That's how good it is, because you get to talking about that onion powder and that garlic powder. She said, I use bacon in my greens. Bacon? Is that what you own? Where your ham shank? What's going on here? Where your smoked turkey tails? Kamala, we gonna need you to bag up off this black act that you trying to pull on us. We can't take it no more. And y'all, I'm convinced, part of me can't wait for the election to be over. Now, of course, I want it to go a certain way. Of course. But a part of me can't wait for it to be over. We got about 70 more days of these shenanigans. And one thing's for certain, two things for sure. After this election is over, no matter which way it goes, if Kamala wins, oh, she gonna stop the charade. She ain't gonna know black folks no more. Conversely, if Kamala loses, she ain't gonna know black folks no more. Either way, y'all, we got about 70 more days of these shenanigans. And hopefully, when it's all said and done, we will all be free from the foolishness and can go back to trying to do the work to build our community without people cosplaying, because everybody want to be black till it's time to be black. Did you learn nothing from Rachel Dolezal? Did you learn nothing from Sean King, aka Talcum X? Y'all, this is unbelievable, and the media is so complicit that they just let her cosplay. She's just out here LARPing along, and the media is just there for it every step of the way. Well, I tell you who ain't here for it. And this is why they release videos like this TikTok video she just put out, because the black community is not here for it in the way that she thought they would be. Her polling is around 70%. You are polling less than Joe Biden in the black community. Y'all, we talking about that Democrat plantation that's used to getting 90%+ of the black vote. Sis, you down to 70% roundabout. And if you follow politics and you follow polling, and you follow the black vote, you know what 70% Democrat vote means for the Democrats. They know what it means too. That's why you're starting to see videos like this. That's why they're flooding social media with content like this. I hope y'all stay awake and pay attention. Not woke, but awake. because there's some shenanigans going on here. And if she really meant what she said and said what she meant, perhaps if she was in touch with Black culture like that, perhaps she would have just fed everybody collard greens and fat back at the DNC. Maybe she would have came out at her rallies and just start serving up some barbecue and some chitlins and some pickled pig feet. But no, she showed you what she really think about you. It's not about food at all, is it? Because she didn't serve up your kind of food at her events. No, she had booty shaking on stage because that's what she really thinks you're about. That was her first attempt when she jumped out there in that water. When she figured out it didn't work, she had to shift gears and say, okay, maybe we'll talk about food because that didn't work. Y'all, it's all a charade.
Hi, I'm Laverne Spicer. And today I watched a video on Twitter or X, whichever one you like. And Kamala was talking about cooking greens with bacon. Now, anybody that cooks greens know that most people that do collard greens are going to use smoked turkey or smoked ham or any type of smoke meat, right? So if you lying about little shit like that, how in the hell you think we supposed to believe the other shit that come out your mouth? Because you just a lying ass, just straight to the point. Just a lying. First of all, what you should be doing is your job as the border czar. Go close that mother border and stop letting all them damn illegals come over here. We have Venezuelan gangs that are reaping havoc in Colorado. They have taken over several apartments. They have AKA assault weapons. All kind of high powered rifles and guns. They also tried to hijack the school bus. Okay, people, get ready, because it started there, but this shit is spreading across the United States. Do you think it's just gonna come to certain neighborhoods? Because no, it's not. This shit gonna come to your motherfucking doorstep too.
You ever feel like somebody trying to fast talk you? Like somebody trying to get over on you? Like somebody's scamming. It's interesting, y'all. That's the vibe and the feeling that this campaign gives me. And if you're in touch with your Black side in the community, I hope red flags are popping up all in your mind. Hope it makes you feel some kind of way. Hope you can't trust it. Y'all, let me know what you think about this and this woman trying to appeal to your sensitivity through under-seasoned food. Y'all like the video? Subscribe to the channel and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.